Hi, welcome to Python tutorial. In this video I will discuss how to write a Python program to find whether the given year is leap year or not a leap year using functions. So first we'll try to understand the logic. We used to say that a given year is a leap year if it is divisible by 4. For example, if the year is 2000, or you can say that 2008, or you can say that 2004, these numbers are divisible by 4 in this case. So we used to say that these numbers are divisible by because they are divisible by 4, we used to say that these are leap years. And if you take some numbers like 2100, or you can say that 1900, these are also divisible by you can say that 4, but these are not leap years. Okay, the first three are leap years, but this is not a leap year. These are leap years. This is a leap year. This is a leap year. This is also a leap year. Now, how to differentiate these things? So, if you see here, a particular year which is divisible by 4, but not by 100. If you look at this particular thing, it is divisible by 100. This is also divisible by 100. This is also divisible by 100. So, first, what we do here is this is divisible by 400 also. For example, 1600. That is also a leap year. So, what we do here is we'll write some conditions. A number year, if the year is divisible by 400, it is a leap year. That's the first thing. If the year is divisible by 4, okay, if the year is divisible by 4 but not by 100, which is that? This one. A year is divisible by 4 but not by 100. 2004 is divisible by 4 but not by 100. 2008 is divisible by 4 but not by 100. So it is a leap year. When it comes to this one, 2100, it is divisible by 4 as well as by 100. So it is not a leap year in this case. So these are some conditions we need to understand here. Okay. Now what I do is I'll try to write the program for this one. It's a very simple program. What I supposed to do is I need to read the year first. So year is equivalent to, I assume that it is an integer number. So definitely year will be integer only. I use input function to read the year. I ask user to enter the year with the help of this statement. Now once the year is read, it will be stored into year variable. Now what I supposed to do? What is the first condition I need to check? Whether year is divisible by 400. If it is equivalent to 0, that is 400, it is divisible by 400, the meaning of that one is print, can say that it's a leap year. Leap year. Or you can say that I will write year is leap year. Okay, so whatever the number you read, that will be printed here. That's a simple condition. If it is divisible by 400, it's a leap year. 2000, 1600, 2400, and so on. Else, if, what is the condition here? There are two conditions I need to check. It should be divisible by 4, but not by 100. That is year mod 4, which is equivalent to 0, and year mod 100 should not be equal to 0. That is, year should be divisible by 4 but not by 100. In such case, I used to say that is year is you can say that leap year. What is the last condition? Else. That is else print whatever the year we have read, that is year this is not the case, year is not leap year. This is a very simple program. This is how actually we used to write the program. So if I execute this part of thing, I'll just give the same examples. That is our 2000, it's a leap year, that's perfectly fine. 2004 is a leap year, that's perfectly fine. We'll take one more example, 2100, it's not a leap year, that's perfectly fine. What about 1900, it is not a leap year. I will execute one more thing, that is 1600, it should be a leap year, and so on. So this is how actually we can write a program to find whether a given year is leap year or not. But actually what they are asking us to do is, they are asking us to use the functions. It's a normal program. If you want to convert it into functions, it can be very easily done. What I supposed to do is all these things, all these statements should go into a definition part, like a def, I will say that the leap year function is, the name of the function is leap. Okay, it doesn't accept, it will accept one parameter, let us say that year, and within that we need to paste all these things. Okay, so every statement will go within this particular definition. And then what I need to do is, first I need to read the year from user. So I will read this year, I will use this statement, I will come to this particular part. This is the definition part, this is the main part. We have read the year. Next I need to call that leap here with the help of this parameter, that is year. Now if I execute it again, 2000, this is a leap year. And then if I execute 2100 is not a leap year, and so on. Okay, it's a very simple program here. With this program we will be able to check whether a given year is a leap year or not. I hope the logic is clear and the program is clear. That's a normal program as well as the program with respect to a function. So if you like the video, do like and share with your friends. Press the subscribe button for more videos. Press the bell icon for regular updates. Thank you for watching.